Let's just for the sake of our imaginations, assume that I'm the local loan shark and you need a dollar for whatever purposes to feed your children or start a business or buy a new suit, whatever it may be. And you come to me and you say, "Sal, I need a dollar. I need to borrow it for roughly a year, and I'm going to get a great job, or my children will get a great job, and I'll pay you back in a year." And I say, "Oh, that sounds very good." And I will lend you a dollar for the low price or the low interest rate of 100% annual interest. So if you borrow $1, if you at 100% interest, if you borrow a dollar, in a year from now, I want that dollar back, and I also want 100% of that. That's the interest rate. The interest rate is essentially what percentage of the original amount you borrowed. That's called the principal in finance terms. That's how much I'm essentially charging you to borrow the money. So it'll be $1 principal. That's what you're borrowing. And of course you have to pay that back. Plus 100% interest. $1. That's 100%, right? 100% interest. And a year from now, you are going to pay me the principal plus the interest, so you are going to pay me $2. Well, you're fairly desperate, so you say, "Okay, Sal, that's okay." But seeing that this isn't the lowest interest rate that you've ever seen, I think the federal funds rate is at something like 2.5% or 3%. So clearly, my 100% is what would make any loan shark proud. You figure, well, I want to pay this thing off as soon as possible. So you say, "Sal, what happens if I have the money in 6 months?" Well, I say, "Okay, that's reasonable. For 6 months, since you're only borrowing it for half as long, I tell you what. I will lend you. You just have to pay me 50% after 6 months." So this is after 1 year. 1 year. After 6 months, I want you to pay $1 principal plus 50% interest, plus 50 cents. Right? That's 50%. And the logic being that, if I'm charging you 100%, I'm charging you a dollar for you to keep the money for the whole year, I'm only going to charge you half as much to keep the money half of the year. And so after 6 months, I would expect you to pay me $1.50. $1.50. And this is after 6 months. And then you say, "Okay, Sal, that makes sense so far. But let's just say that I intend to pay you back in 6 months, but just in case I don't have the money in 6 months, will I still just owe you $2 in a year?" And I say, no. That I can't deal with, because now I'm giving you the possibility of paying off earlier, and if you pay this money earlier, then I have to figure out where I'm going to essentially who I'm going to take advantage of next. While if I just lock in my money with you, I can take advantage of you for an entire year. So what I say is, what you're going to have to do is essentially re-borrow the money after 6 months for another 6 months. So instead of me charging you 50 cents for the next 6 months, I'm going to charge you 50% for the next 6 months. So this is how you can view it. You, in day one, you borrow a dollar from me. In 6 months, you pay $1.50, right? And we decided that 50% was a fair interest rate for 6 months, right? So let's say that you really do need the money for a year. So we will just charge you another 50% for that next 6 months. Now, that other 50%, it's not going to be on your initial principal. Now, after 6 months, you owe me $1.50. So I'm going to charge you. So this is starting of the next period. You'd owe me $1.50. And now I'm going to charge you 50% of that. So that's 75 cents. So still a 50% interest rate for the 6 months. But your principal is increased, right? Because it was the old principal plus the old interest, and that's how much you owe me now. And now I'm going to charge the interest rate on that. And so now that equals $2.25 over a year. So you look at that and you're like, "Wow, just to be able to essentially have this option to pay earlier, I'm essentially on an annual rate. My annual rate looks a lot more like 125% interest, right? Because my original principal, your original principal was a dollar, and now you're paying $1.25 in interest. So you're paying 125% annual rate. So that looks pretty bad to you, but you are, I guess, in a tough bind. So you agree to it, And I explained to you that this is actually just a very common thing, even though it looks suspicious to you. It's called compounding interest. It means that after every period, if we say something compounds twice a year, after every 6 months, we take the interest off of the new amount that you owe me. You could pay me back what you owe me at that point, or you could essentially reborrow it at the same rate for another 6 months. So you say, okay, Sal, you're overwhelming me a little bit, but I need the money, so I'll do it. But once again, you know, on an annual basis, 125% looks even worse. You know, 50% over 6 months still isn't cheap. What if I have the money in a month? What if I have the money in a month? Where I say, okay, here's the deal. Same notion. Instead of charging you 100%, instead of charging you 100% per year, I'm going to charge you. So this is scenario one. This is scenario two. I'm going to charge you 1/12 of that. I'm going to charge you 100% divided by 12, and what is that? It's 12 goes into 8.5%, 8.5 times, right? Yeah, 8 times 12 is 96, and then you get another half in there, right? So now I'll say, well, if you want to pay me on any given month, I'll just charge you 8.5% per month. And once again, though, it's going to compound. So let's say you start with $1. After 1 month, you're going to owe me that $1 plus 8.5%. So after 1 month, you're going to owe me 1 plus 8.5% of 1. So plus 0.85, which equals 1.085. And then after a month, you're going to owe me this plus 8.5% of this. So it would be essentially 1.085 squared. And you can do the math to figure that out. And then after 3 months, you'll owe me 1.085 to the third. And after a full year, you'll actually owe me 1.085 to the 12th power. And let's see what that is. I'm going to use my little Excel here. Let's see, if I have plus 1.085 to the 12th, you'll owe me $2.66. That equals $2.66. And you say, okay, that's acceptable, reluctantly, because this is now, what, 166% effective interest rate. And just keep in mind, all I'm doing is I'm compounding the interest, right? This was $1.08, and I think that makes sense to you. And the reason why this is squared is because this is just this principle times 1.085. Another way to view it is this is the same thing as, let me do it in a different color, as it's equivalent to this plus 0.085 times 1.085. Right? So it's 1.085 plus 0.085 times 1.085. So if you think of this as 1 times 1.085 and this is 0.085 times 1.085, then you can take out the 1.085 and you would essentially get 1.085 times 1.085. And it keeps going. And so now in this situation, we are compounding the interest. We said it's essentially 100% interest, but we're dividing it by 12 per month, but we're compounding it 12 times. So in general, what's the formula if I want to compound it n times? So how much are you going to have to pay me at the end of a year? Well, let's say you want to pay every day. If you want the ability to pay every day, and I say that's okay, so each day per day, I'll charge you 100%, which was my original annual rate, divided by, say, 365 days in a year. But I'm going to compound it every day. So after every day, you're going to owe 1 point, what is this number? Let's see. That number is 100 divided by 365. Whoops, plus 100 divided by 365. So it's 2, that's 0.27%. So 0.27%. After every day, you're going to owe me this much times the previous day. So after 365 days, you're going to owe me this to the 365th power. So in general, I just realized I ran out of time, so I will continue this in the next video.